Climate activists show no sign of slowing down as they prepare to march across the country today, despite mass arrests during yesterday's action. We have team coverage of the protests this morning. Christina Hearn is in Melbourne and Gabrielle Boyle is in Sydney. Let's go to you first, Chris. And police there have been forced to take action.
Yeah, that's right, Ali. Last night, 10 people were arrested. The climate movement group Extinction Rebellion moved into the city, shutting down several major intersections, sitting on the streets, chanting, singing songs. They ended up on the corner of Swanston and Flinders Street, of course, one of the biggest intersections in Melbourne, blocking traffic, causing peak hour chaos. Police ordered them to move when they had failed to do so after about an hour. Police had had enough. They moved in and forcibly removed the activists. Of the 10 arrested, 8 have been fined, 2 charged with intentionally obstructing an emergency worker. 1 was bailed, but 1 man refused to enter the bail agreement, so remains in custody this morning. The intersection cleared about 7:30 last night. Let's have a listen to what one protester had to tell us.
I know that I'm doing the right thing by sitting there protesting for this earth with everybody else. The amazing amount of people on the sidelines cheering for us. We will continue protesting for this earth with our physical bodies and our voices, using all our resources. So every person out there, use your resources.
I'm here at the group's base at Carlton Gardens. As you can see, they've been camping here for the night, and the plan is to use this as a base. So all the protesters gather here, then they will swarm more city streets, vowing to cause more disruptions during this morning's peak as part of this week-long activism. Ali?
They look pretty settled in there. Thank you, Chris. Let's go to Gabrielle Boyle now, who's at the Surry Hills Police Station in Sydney. And Gabby, can we expect equally chaotic scenes today?
We certainly can, Ali. This group has promised a week of chaos. That's what we got yesterday, and that is what we are expecting again today. Here in Sydney, there are 2 protests scheduled, the first of which is at Hyde Park at 9 a.m, and then they move to Town Hall Square at 11:30. Yesterday, we saw some pretty aggressive scenes here in Sydney's CBD. We had about 400 protesters, 30 of which were arrested. And take a look at those scenes that we saw spreading through Sydney yesterday. Today. They started at Central Station and made their way to Broadway, taking over the streets. Some of those protesters even inside a water tank as it was rolled along the street. Police, as I said, making 30 arrests, bringing most of those protesters here to Surry Hills Police Station. We haven't got the exact numbers on how many have been charged as yet, but certainly police say they are pretty frustrated with their behaviour. Yesterday, of course, was a public holiday, but today things are going to be very different in Sydney's CBD because we are expecting everyone back at work. So it's going to be business as usual for those 2 protests. Let's take a look a little of what those protesters had to say.
Even if it doesn't necessarily go perfectly as planned, at least there's attention drawn towards it.
It will go on. You'll find for the next week, people are going to come out, stand up. What else can we do?
Yes, there's certainly some pretty chaotic scenes, and we can expect more of that today, Ali.
OK, thank you, Gabby. Gabrielle Boyle in Sydney and Christina Hearn in Melbourne, kicking off our coverage.
Hi, YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.